Can the coronavirus damage your heart? We know that around 80% of people falling ill with the new coronavirus can expect a rather mild illness that doesn't require hospital treatment. The chance of developing the severe form of the disease and dying of COVID-19 increased significantly, however, if you have a pre-existing health condition, like heart disease or hypertension. But what about previously healthy people, people who had no heart problems whatsoever? Can getting the coronavirus actually damage your heart? Stay tuned to find out and make sure to hit the subscribe button if you want to keep up with all the great medical content I publish every week. To survive and reproduce inside its human host, the new coronavirus will need to enter human cells. It does this by attaching to ACE2 receptor proteins located on the outer surface of those cells. These ACE2 receptors are found on cells in the lungs, which explains why the coronavirus typically attacks the lungs, and why so many hospitalized coronavirus patients require ventilators. ACE2 receptors are also found in heart cells, however, and so you can't help but ask yourself if the coronavirus can use the ACE2 receptors to enter and infect lung cells, can it not find those same receptors on heart tissue and attach to them, infecting the heart muscle? We already know of many viruses that infect the heart muscle, causing a condition known as viral myocarditis. Myocarditis meaning inflammation of the heart muscle. The most notorious culprit is Coxsackie virus type B. Coxsackie virus is an RNA virus like the new coronavirus. Upon infecting the heart, it brings with it a tide of white blood cells causing endless damage that can, in the long run, result in a dilated cardiomyopathy, heart failure. A recent case report from Italy seems to support the suggestion that the new coronavirus could and does infect the heart. An otherwise healthy 53-year-old female patient fell ill with COVID-19. During the course of her illness, she developed heart damage in the absence of any involvement of the lungs. Her heart function remained compromised throughout her illness and did not recover even after the infection resolved. Moreover, a significant number of patients hospitalized due to COVID-19 were found to have elevated cardiac enzymes on admission. Cardiac enzymes are an important laboratory indicator of damage to the heart tissue, and according to one study, were a better indicator of mortality, patient death, than the presence of pre-existing cardiovascular disease. Before you start losing sleep over all this, remember that heart damage isn't typical in mild cases of COVID-19 and only tends to happen in the more severe forms of the disease. As I said at the beginning of the video, 80% of people who fall ill with the coronavirus will likely experience mild symptoms and will not require hospitalization nor suffer any heart damage. So try not to stress out too much about it. If you like this video, then don't keep it a secret. Tell the YouTube algorithm. You can do that by pressing the like button. If you loved it, then you can become a blue specker and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date with all the great medical content I publish each and every week. If you really hated this video, then you should subscribe to the channel anyway. That way you'll get to keep tabs on just how terrible all my future videos are. In any case, you should find links below so you can do some further reading on this topic. Until next week then.